BCTV receives state arts funding support through a grant from the Pennsylvania Council on the Arts, a state agency. Funded by the Commonwealth of Pennsylvania and the National Endowment for the Arts, a federal agency.
Welcome to The Institute Presents. I'm Susan Rohn, the director, and today we have an illustrious group with us, starting with Janet Henshaw, who is a quilter, who has brought her work with us today so that she can show us exactly what she does. You didn't know that, did you? And Joy Davies, who is participating in Dancing with the Reading Stars, and her partner, Erich Cawalla, who is also participating in Dancing with the Reading Stars. And of course, Debbie Silas, a well-known face at the Institute. She is also participating in Dancing with the Reading Stars. Welcome. And we have another one with us too.
He's hiding down there.
Would you like to introduce him?
This is Zachary Lee. And he's also dancing in the Reading Stars.
So if you don't have tickets, you may want to get them. Because he is going to be the star of the show.
Yes, he is.
That's what he thinks.
Right,
Zach. Anyway, let's start with the quilts. We have this fabulous exhibit at the Institute right now, and it's one unlike any we usually have. We wanted to do a textile exhibit, and one of our board members said, you should go to Landis Store and look at the quilts they have there, because they're going to look great in this gallery. So we went out, we visited Janet, and Janet is with us today. And she can tell us a little bit more about the quilts. We have some really interesting quilts to show you. And they will be at the Institute until April 23rd. So please stop by if you get the opportunity. So Janet, how did this happen? Maybe you want to tell us.
As to how I got into the exhibit?
How did you get into the exhibit?
Well, you were down for dinner at our restaurant and asked me if I would like to exhibit the quilts, which I was very honored to be asked that. So we did, but I started quilting probably about 20 years ago. Mm-hmm. That was always my dream to quilt, but it didn't happen until about 20 years ago, and I took one class on applique, and I was hooked.
You were hooked on it. But you were always sewing. You said you grew up at Landis Store. This is interesting. She's now, you know, she's been there all her life.
Yes. We moved to Landis Store back in 52, and it was a country store and a bar. And I used to work in the store. But we had this one back room, so I set up my sewing machine and I would make clothing. And I made my clothing, my mother's clothing, my sister's clothing, friends' clothing. And I also sewed for my home ec teacher. And I did that for years. And then after my husband and I took over the restaurant, it became a restaurant in 1970. And we got too busy, so sewing took a back burner until about 20 years ago when I ended up buying a new sewing machine and they had classes there and I took this one class which ended up in being lots of quilts.
Well, you have lots of quilts and I'd like to show you some of them and maybe we can talk a little bit about them.
Sure.
So the first one.
That one is named Bento Boxes.
Right.
And I saw sort of an idea in one of the Japanese quilting books that I had. And I started it, and I changed it around a bit, and then it sort of got put on a shelf because I wasn't sure how I was going to finish it. But I finally did, and it's done with a lot of Oriental or Japanese fabrics. And that's applique. They're just boxes, and it's named bento boxes.
That's one of my favorites. It really is. It's on the postcard. And it's, I mean, it was just, it's a fabulous piece. Really a fabulous piece. Very unusual. Okay, now we're going to go to the next one. These are your baby quilts, aren't they?
These are what I call my baby quilts. I'm not the traditional pink and baby blue. I like to do different ones, and I love polka dots.
Yes, so do I. I do, and it's great. And I think this one, I believe, was sold.
Oh.
Yes, I believe okay. This is the one, the first thing that was sold was this one.
Okay. Mm-hmm.
One of our board members actually bought it.
Okay.
He loved it. Okay. Is this the geese?
That one's, I call it flying a kite with a glass of wine.
Okay. Ah, with a glass of wine. Well, that fits into the opening. The opening reception was very similar.
The center is their kite blocks, and our quilt guild does, they do a block of the month. So whatever the block is, whoever makes it, you put it up on the design wall and put your name in a paper bag, and at the end of the guild meeting, they pick a name out of anybody that entered a block, and I happened to win the blocks. There were maybe 8 or 10 of them, so I thought, well, I'll make more of them, and I'll do a quilt, which I did, and I wasn't real thrilled about it, and neither was my husband, and so I thought it needed something, so I did the flying geese around the outside of it. And then the dark border, I did a different quilting technique that I hadn't done before. And it should be straight lines, but they're not all real straight, and that's why I decided to call it flying a kite with a glass of wine.
Were you drinking a glass of wine when you did it?
Oh, I don't know. I could have. I don't
No, it's memorable. Now, all the blocks that were in the bag that you won.
Yes.
Okay. Are they all incorporated in
yes.
this piece? So
yes,
everyone that was in that bag.
Everyone that I, you know, got that night is in that quilt.
It's a great piece and creative. Oh, and this is one of my favorites too because of the story. How long did it take you?
About 8 years.
Oh, wow. 8 years.
And they're little 3/4-inch hexagons, which I used a lot of my fabric stash scraps and covered them and made them into flowers. And I do that when we travel. I always have something with me usually to work on. So over about 8 years, I finished all these and put them together. And I counted them. I think it's over 5,000 hexagons in that quilt.
Wow. So 8 years because you couldn't take a sewing machine with you, right?
Correct.
You're on vacation?
Yes.
This was your vacation quilt. It's lovely. It really is lovely. That one, is that one for sale?
Yes.
Is it?
Okay. It is.
I wasn't sure mm-hmm. if that was too precious to part with.
Well, I have so many, so it's like, if somebody really wants to buy, you know, I would sell them.
It's a great piece.
Thank you.
And here we go. So this is another baby
quilt. That's another baby quilt.
There's the photography. I did it. With my cell phone. And I have to get pictures of these. And these are the oranges and the yellows.
Yes.
You use
and
so
I think,
much in these.
And I think on the back of that one has the cats and dogs.
Oh, I should have photographed
that. Yes, I think it does. And that's all in orange. It's the same color.
I didn't turn it over. And this one's black and white. Doesn't look so black and white in here.
That one was through the quilt show, which is an online quilt show with Alex Anderson and Ricky Timms. And every year they have a quilt that they give you, they call it the block of the month. So they'll give you a certain part of that quilt the first month, and in that one, they start at the center. So it did that center star, and then the next month it was probably, can't tell, is that flying geese or half square triangles? Anyway, every month they give you a different part of it, and after 12 months, if you followed it, you should be finished with it.
Okay, is this the romance? Is that the name of it?
Yes, I think it is. Black and white romance. Yes.
Yeah. It's very unlike most quilts that you see, just the color.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
Okay, and then we have another one of those. And this one, which is sideways, unfortunately.
You should be able to turn that. See those arrows there?
Yes. Now, wait a minute. Let me see if I can get there. There you go.
There. That one, after I started quilting, my son asked me to make him a quilt with his airplane on it. And I said, it has to be your airplane, and he said, yes. So I got the background fabric, which was the turquoise, and I sort of played around with it for a while, and I thought, oh gosh. So I put it on the shelf, and it sat on the shelf for 12 years, and he stopped asking me about it, because I think he said everybody else gets a quilt but him. But so I got it out one day, and I did it, and I did it in applique. I had pictures of his airplane, which I enlarged and made pieces of it to do the applique. And then I put all the information from his logbook of flying on it, of when he had his first lesson, when he soloed, when he did his check flight. And then around the edge are all the airports and identifying numbers of the airports that he flew into. Across the top, those airports are when he flew it with his dad to Oshkosh, to the big air show. And I remember them, they were following Route 80 from the air at one point, and cars and trucks were going faster than his airplane was.
That's a good story.
And anyway, and the bottom one has the same or different airports that when he and his wife flew it. And on the back of that quilt, I don't know if you took a picture of that.
I didn't.
Is the Oshkosh airport where they have the big air show. And I have the runways on there. And the runways are so long that they have colored dots on them. And they, when you're flying into that air show, they tell you which dot to land on.
Huh.
Mm-hmm. It's really interesting. But,
well,
so that's a very interesting quilt.
It gets people in to see it. Now you can come in and sneak behind and look behind
it. You can look behind it.
Because they're hung in a way that you can actually.
Yes, and there's more information on the back of that quilt also.
Okay. And we're back to
bento boxes,
but we already talked about that. I think that's the one you sent me. Now this one, is this one in the show? I don't.
No, that one's Poppies of England.
That's right.
That
one is in the show.
No, that one's not. That one's in the one that is in a book. That is Flowers for My Valentine, and it was in the Houston International Quilt Show, and one of the judges, I believe, contacted me and asked if I would allow it to be in a book that she was doing. So it is in the book 500 Traditional Quilts, which they sell at the Houston show. I thought about bringing the book, but I didn't.
Well,
but that one's all applique, and it's basically red and white. There are some other colors in it, though, also. And that one I designed.
Well, this has been a great show. And I can't thank you enough for doing it.
Well, thank you.
And we're hoping to have you come back in the future.
With more different ones.
New things that you've done, because it's creative and it's fun and it's something different. But thank you for doing this. And anybody have any questions for Janet?
No, your work is beautiful.
Thank you.
It is. You can come into the Institute and see the backs of all the quilts.
Yes.
But we don't have them here. So that gives you an incentive to come in. So I think we better move on to Dancing with the Reading Stars, our next big event at the Institute, April. It's not at the Institute, it's sponsored by the Institute, April 21st at the Doubletree. And we have three of our dancers with us today. And we can start with Joy and Erich, who are dancing. And how did you get involved?
She asked me to do it.
Yeah, okay. Joy, how did you find out about it?
Well, Lisa Tiger comes into the salon, and she was talking about it. And Louise Gannis is her stylist, and she said, oh, Joy, you know, you should do it. And I took lessons at the Institute years ago.
You said growing up.
Yes, so I loved it, and especially knowing the different programs that you have and different communities, that really touched base with me to let all the communities know, hey, these programs are for all of our youth, which is very important.
It is. It's very important.
Yes.
Debbie, how did you get involved?
Well, you called me and said,
Debbie.
Debbie, actually, I'm a theater teacher at the Yoakum Institute. And just this past year, I started a dance class at the Institute for young adults with special needs. And the Institute was, you know, welcoming us to come and do our class there. Several years ago, I did choreography for one of my former students, and Jackie Hoffman-Wenrick. They danced in Dancing with the Reading Stars, and I did their choreography. And I said to Susan at one of the meetings that we were at, I'd like to do that sometime. Well, she gives me a call and says, hey, you know, what do you, find yourself a partner. Okay. That was my whole thing. I don't have a partner. And I guess you felt the same way. You had to find yourself a partner. She suggested I ask my son, and I didn't, because I figured he'd say no. And then when I found a partner, then he said, well, why didn't you ask me? You know. But my partner is Brian Miller. I am the president of Reading Community Players, a local community theater. And Brian is the treasurer. So we are dancing kind of as Reading Community Players. So it's a nonprofit supporting another nonprofit because of the great work that they do at the Institute. And it's just like a companion kind of, you know, two organizations helping each other out. So we're having a great time, and it's been a lot of fun. And, you know, it is what it is. But, you know, we're having fun. And, you know, it's a great experience, especially for somebody who has never danced before, you know. And I think we have a lot of people that are competing that really, they're not dancers.
They're not dancers, exactly.
Okay, so I mean, it's a whole different way of looking at things. And we were just talking here earlier about dancing at the studio and dancing in front of a mirror, and the first time you go away from that mirror, how uncomfortable it is not having that little crutch to see yourself doing what you're supposed to be doing. And but Anne, thank you for inviting us, because
I'm
it's been a lot
you
of
could
fun.
Join us, believe me, you're doing well, doing very well. Well, Joy and Erich, how has this experience been for you?
Well, for me, it's I'm a musician in the area, perform with the Uptown Band, and you know, I play sax, and that's my element. This is totally not my element. The closest thing that this is was when I was in Governor Mifflin. We had a group called the Governors and First Ladies, and we would, you know, sing and dance. It was the show choir over there. And I wasn't any good then, but I actually think I've moderately improved. Yeah, I've actually moderately improved over the last 20 years.
Who's your coach?
Kim Feltenberger.
Yep,
okay.
Kim's been doing a great job, and I think she designed a dance for me that's not too crazy, so I don't, you know. Because it is out of my element, and it's something I've never really done before, and I am a bit nervous about it. How many people are going to be at the Doubletree?
Well, at least 500.
Yeah, well, that's nothing.
Minimum. We're a little over 500.
You don't know anybody, just pretend, you know.
Yeah. But no, I mean, it's been exhausting at times, but for me, it's the whole thing about getting out of your element. I think in life you have to do that, and anything that
taking
you do.
Taking a risk.
You got to take risks in life, yep, no matter what you do, and obviously what it supports mm-hmm. you know, the arts and the so arts. Forth is makes it so much better.
Arts and outreach mm-hmm. and
yep.
production
mm-hmm. yep.
and you know, instruction in the arts.
Yep.
Yes.
I think it's a great opportunity. Like we said, the, you know, the majority of the people that are dancing are not dancers, and it just to take that risk to go outside your mm-hmm. comfort zone, and you just have to go on it and do whatever you can do and smile and have
yep.
fun, and no one's going to judge you. It doesn't really matter. It's for a good mm-hmm. cause, and it's just fun.
I think some
yeah.
people are going to
yeah.
judge me. My parents.
Yeah, well, but you know, I know. Oh, look at him, he's so cute out there.
Actually, my mom will probably think it's great. My dad.
Well, dads are always the biggest
yeah.
fans.
Oh, yeah.
I did the chicken dance. You can't do any worse. Oh. I couldn't learn anything.
The
first year, my partner and I.
Wow.
It was insane. And we were falling all over each other, and
we
know neither
that.
One of us had time to
what?
Practice.
The chicken dance.
So we did the chicken dance. We didn't tell anybody. And we got up there, and it looked like it was going to be
yeah.
really, really, you know,
that's
formal.
That's actually
And
cool.
then we just broke into
the
it.
The chicken dance.
It was.
That's
and we
great.
Had masks. He went out and got masks. Head,
oh,
head
my
masks.
Goodness.
So we put them on.
Chicken head masks?
We went to Myers Costume Shop. We had so much fun.
Oh,
I mean,
goodness.
The whole place just broke up.
Oh,
I
got
laughing.
Yeah.
And everybody got up and did the chicken dance.
That's
great. We had a video. It was fun.
Did you get the audience choice for that then?
Oh, no, I
no.
didn't. They the judges then, and they
oh,
even
they,
refused
I
to
see.
Judge us.
Oh,
they just threw us out.
Isn't it funny that the director is the one that doesn't get judged? I
yeah.
love that.
No, they couldn't. They wouldn't even, because there was one really stern judge there.
Yeah.
And he was going to, he was a dancer, and he was going to tell
Steadfast.
People exactly what they did wrong. He couldn't even tell us. Because it was like unprecedented. Well, Joy, how's it going for you?
It's going well.
And you have a dance background.
Yes, I do, but it's been so many years, it's hard to get back into it. Like you were saying, if it's out of your element, well, I've been out of it for so long, and you don't realize how rusty you are until you get there. Like, whoa, what happened these past couple years? So, but it's fun, and the fundraisers we're having is going
great. Well, you've had great. A number of fundraisers.
You know, yeah, I love doing that, and... You know,
how did they go? You
together.
Had a soul food one. You had
a soul food
one,
a spaghetti one.
You have one coming up Friday night.
Yeah, that's Erich's Bandapalooza. And
yeah.
Saturday will be our finale. And that's just have a buffet and mm-hmm. a DJ. H. Fidel will be DJing.
Right.
And so that'll be, it's going to be a good time.
Yeah.
Everyone's
it is a good time.
Fun.
Everybody's
yeah,
had a good
yeah,
time.
Yeah,
they
and
really
just
have. You usually
to get
do.
Support from yeah. people really makes you feel good. And just for the cause and everything. And letting them know, too, hey, this is for all of us here.
Exactly.
You know,
it
the
is.
Togetherness is very important.
We have quite a group of dancers this year. So you can go on our website and see mm-hmm. everybody, because if I repeat them, I may miss one. So I don't want to insult anyone. So please go on our website. We really do have some fabulous people dancing. And spring term at the Institute starts Saturday. I think there's still room in some of the classes, so feel free to call and if you're interested in anything or stop by. And I thank everybody for joining us and come see us at Dancing with the Reading Stars.
Yeah.
See you
stay
next month.
For us.
BCTV receives state arts funding support through a grant from the Pennsylvania Council on the Arts, a state agency. funded by the Commonwealth of Pennsylvania and the National Endowment for the Arts, a federal agency.